luck building the platform yet?
I glued a bunch of parts together and hoped for the best. Good enough?
Hey, you're the one that's gonna be standing on the thing. Here's a list of everything we'll need. Now, I know some of that might as well be in Greek, so I'll be around if you have any questions.
Looks good, Ingram. I'll get to work right away.
I wish I had your confidence. Oh, one last thing before I forget. It's important that all the components are wired together so all the pieces are on a single grid. If you need any help, I'll be over at the build site making some adjustments and calculations. I'd wish you good luck, Knight, but I think we're both going to need it.
Thank you. you could travel with that thing makes me seriously question your judgment, soldier.
Proctor,
do you need any help with the signal interceptor?
Not now.
You still have a lot more to do.
Proctor Ingram?
We're close. All we need is enough power to fire up the signal interceptor. Check all your connections and make sure all the components are wired together on a single grid.
Remarkable work, Knight. Just come back here, Knight. You aren't going near that teleporter until you've heard me out.
Elder Maxson?
Remarkable work, Knight. The signal interceptor appears to be complete. Are you ready to put it to the test?
Lab rats standing by.
All of us are aware of the risks you're taking, and we salute you. That being said, this is the first time we've attempted to directly adapt Institute technology. When we throw that switch, we don't know exactly what's gonna happen. God willing, you'll end up inside the Institute, and the mission can continue.
What are the details of my mission?
I'm glad you asked. Now, I want you to listen very carefully. Once you've entered the Institute, we expect to lose contact, so it's imperative you remember everything I'm about to tell you. About 10 years ago, the Brotherhood began recruiting civilian scientists from the Capital Wasteland to assist with various projects. During this process, we were able to obtain the services of Dr. Madison Lee, a noted mind in the field of nuclear engineering.
How did the Brotherhood meet Dr. Lee?
She was part of a civilian project in the Capital Wasteland that the Brotherhood appropriated. It wasn't difficult to convince her to stay. That said, Dr. Lee's contributions to our cause were instrumental in maintaining order in the Capital Wasteland. After some time, she developed differences with the Brotherhood and exiled herself to the Commonwealth. We're fairly certain that her intent was to make contact with the Institute.
What sort of differences?
Although she was working with the Brotherhood of Steel, she never formally joined as a scribe. After the Capital Wasteland was secured, she objected to the Brotherhood's continued military presence there. I think she assumed we would just walk away from it all. She was wrong. Your mission is simple. Once you're inside the Institute, we want you to track down Dr. Lee's whereabouts. If you find out that she's still alive, make contact with her and convince her to return to the Brotherhood of Steel. There's a special project we're working on.
What's this project that needs her attention?
Dr. Lee previously worked on a potent weapon for... We'd like her to continue where she left off. Listen to me, Knight. I'm well aware that you're risking your life going into the Institute blind. Just keep your mind on the mission. And don't let anything they say sway you from your duty. Good luck.
I've checked and rechecked everything. I think the signal interceptor's ready to go. Are you?
Let's do this.
All right. Head up onto the platform and we'll... Are you in or are you out? Make up your mind. Let's see. Relays dialed in. Beam emitters warmed up. Everything looks green. Let me start scanning for the signal. Cross your fingers. I'm inputting the code now. Wow, there's a heck of a lot of interference and ghosting. It's gonna take a minute or two to lock in. By the way, this little trip you're taking is a heck of an opportunity to find out as much as we can about the Institute and what they're up to. I put a clever little program on this holotape that'll scan their network and download anything it finds. If you place it in any terminal down there, it'll do the rest. Bring it back to me and I'll see if I can make sense of whatever it found. Well, well, looks like we have a winner! RF wave capture complete. Ramping the emitter. 60%, 80%. Emitter spiking but steady. All that's left is to throw the transmit switch. Transmitting in 3, 2, 1. Stay safe, soldier.
You have your assignment, soldier. Move out.
I wondered if you might make it here. You're quite resourceful. I'm known as Father. The Institute is under my guidance. I know why you're here. I'd like to discuss things with you face to face.
Useless.
Please, step into the elevator. can only imagine what you've heard, what you think of us. I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression. Welcome to the Institute. This is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people, the work we do. For over 100 years, we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials, a shared vision of how science can help shape the future. It has never been easy. And our actions are often misinterpreted by those above ground. Someday, perhaps, we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now, we must remain underground. There's too much at stake here to risk it all. As you've seen, things above are unstable. I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that can wait. You are here for a specific, very personal reason. You are here for your son.
Broken. We need the key. No way to pick this. Sean?
Yes, I'm Sean.
God damn them. So many years stolen.
Who are you?
These bad people, they stole you from me.
Father, what's going on? What's happening?
Those bastards. They killed your father.
What's going on? Father? Father!
I'll kill him for this.
I don't know you. Go away. Father! Father, help me! There's someone here! Help me!
Who is Father? Where is he?
Father? Father, help! Father, help me!
Sensor anomaly detected.
It's stuck.
Please come out.
Now I understand. You are hiding because
I can't believe
this. You are still there.
Sean. S923, recall code Cirrus. Fascinating, but disappointing. The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a prototype, you understand. We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli. Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew. I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
Give me Sean! The real Sean! Right now!
I know. You've gone to such lengths to find him.
I'll make this very simple. Where is my son?
He's here, in the Institute. Closer than you think. But I need you to realize that this... You have traveled very far, and suffered a great deal to find your son. It's good to finally meet you, after all this time. It's me. I am Sean. I am... your son.
It's really you. After all this time.
Yes. It's true. In the vault, you had no concept of the passage of time. But then you learned that your son was no longer an infant, but a 10-year-old boy. You believed that 10 years had passed. Is it really so hard to accept that it was not 10, but 60 years? And here I am.
It wasn't right, what they did. Taking you from me like that.
To you, that would certainly seem true. But to the Institute, it made all the sense in the world. At that time, the year 2227, the Institute had made great strides in synth production, but it was never enough. Scientific curiosity and the goal of perfection drove them ever onward, so they followed the best example thus far.
So the weird science experiments needed specimens?
In a manner of speaking, yes. The Institute endeavored to create synthetic organics. The most logical starting point, of course, was human DNA. Plenty of that was available, of course. But it had all become corrupted. In this wasteland, radiation affected everyone. Even in their attempts to shield themselves from the world above, members of the Institute had been exposed. But then the Institute found me, after discovering records from Vault 111. I was exactly what they needed. I am their father. Through science, we are family. I know you must have questions.
Your father... he never got to see you grow up.
Yes. What happened to him was... I've gone over the records of the incident, of course. It seems what happened to him was an unfortunate bit of collateral damage. For many years, I never questioned who my parents were. With old age comes regret, but what matters now is that you and I have a chance to begin again. What else can I say to ease your mind?
Kellogg, he worked for you?
Kellogg. He was an Institute asset long before I arrived here. It wasn't until I became director that I learned of all the things he'd done.
You knew the man was a psychopath, but you used him anyway?
Would you have preferred that I turned him loose on the Commonwealth? The Institute took advantage of Kellogg's vicious nature. Mm-hmm. Institute technology prolonged his life, and his usefulness far beyond any normal human lifespan. He never failed the Institute, but his cruelty became more apparent with every completed objective. I won't lie. It's no coincidence your path crossed his. What else can I say?
So, you're in charge?
I am the acting director, yes. The Institute. It's important.
Scared of you, Sean. Scared of the Institute.
People are always frightened by what they don't understand. Ultimately, the Commonwealth has nothing to fear from us. Just give me time. I know there's more for us to discuss. But the Institute is on the verge of some important breakthroughs. I've been a part of something amazing here. And now, after all these years, you have an opportunity to help with that. Doesn't that intrigue you?
Yes.
I know. I know you've been through so much. Forgive me. I'd assume that after everything I'm sure you've seen above ground, you would be more than a bit biased against us. There is much to be done. You'll need time to acclimate yourself. A chance to become acquainted with our procedures.
I'll do whatever it takes.
I am glad to hear that. The Institute is now your home, as much as it is mine. You want to introduce yourself to the division heads. And finally, Dr. Lee in Advanced Systems.
It's an honor to have you here, ma'am.
There we go.
I wouldn't be here. Not for your son.
Call this a clean floor. Are your visual receptors malfunctioning? Can you not see the grime and dust?
Welcome to the Institute, ma'am. Always be vigilant. We have many enemies.
Liam, I forgot to tell you. Your friend Brendan came by looking for you.
Thanks. Did he say why?
He mentioned something about studying and then said a lot of scientific words, but I don't think he knew what they meant.
Yeah, that sounds...
Greetings, ma'am.
I'll go find him later. Thanks, Eve.
So Dr. Ayo thinks he can hide in his office, does he? Well, you
Scanning
can tell him
unknown
that
identity.
I intend to speak to Father.
Clearance.
I'm seriously thinking of heading over to robotics to knock some heads together.
What now?
It's an honor to meet you.
Targeting package upgrades I asked for.
You're
Maybe
here?
I should take some courses
Glad you made
with
it.
Me.
We're all looking forward to working with you.
Please don't. There's enough friction
hey,
as
Doc.
It is between
so,
us and pretty much all the other
here
departments.
You are. Justin Ayo, acting director of the Synth Retention Bureau. I'll be up front with you. We're going to be keeping a close eye on you for the near future. Despite your relation to Father, you're a bit of an unknown quantity. I'm sure you understand. There won't be any issues, will there?
Why? Don't you trust me?
I'll be honest. You're an outsider.
The first outsider to be allowed access to the Institute in quite a long time, in fact. It's nothing personal. I assure you.
Now, Father has asked that I provide you with a brief overview. Our primary responsibility is the recovery of escaped synths that are hiding among the human population on the surface.
So, basically, you're the secret police.
Secret police? If that's a pre-war reference, then I'm afraid it's lost on me. Our main instrument is the Courser. Coursers hunt down and reclaim synths. They are highly self-sufficient, trained in combat, infiltration, and tracking. But I gather you know all this, since you've encountered one already. In fact, I'd very much like to know how you defeated it.
I'm no stranger to combat.
Even so, a Courser should be more than a match for any single combatant. I suppose I'll have to ask Robotics to perform detailed diagnostics on the entire production run. Now, unless you need something else, I'll get...
If you're the acting head of the SRB, who are you filling in for?
Dr. Zimmer holds that position.
Uh-huh.
In his absence, I keep things running smoothly. Hi there.
The Directorate should take the synth escapes more seriously.
I hear we're about to get a new food supplement.
Please don't get any germs on me.
Pardon me, ma'am.
If the robotics division was a little more careful, we wouldn't have synths trying to escape.
Dr. Ayo.
Yes? What do you need?
You mentioned that coursers undergo special training.
The SRB constantly monitors our Gen 3 synth population. Those who show tenacity, fearlessness, and independence undergo a rigorous training regimen. We teach them armed and unarmed combat. Those who pass a final evaluation become coursers.
Excuse me.
Subject identified.
No visible reaction from the FTL. We'll start the next trial. The dosage will be much larger.
She's been at it for over 2 hours. What is she even testing?
Nothing. At this point, she's just doing it for fun.
Excuse me, Doctor.
Oh, hi there. Sorry if I seem distracted. I memorized 5 sets of design schematics, and now I'm doing detailed mental comparisons.
That's amazing.
Oh, well, a lot of us do that. Anyway, I'm glad you're here. I really hope you'll stay here with us. Well, that was productive.
Safety first. Remember that.
One day, I'll design a more efficient reactor to replace that.
Excuse me, Dr. Lee.
Oh, it's you. You're not authorized to be here. Where are you going? I thought you wanted to talk.
This is day 8 of trial 6. The last week has been very productive, but exhausting. I think we'll need a break after this. Binet has done some really marvelous work with the personality mesh. It's... well, it's almost too good. The responses map almost identically to expectations, some of the most lifelike I've seen. Of course, it's not really Sean. None of his memories are in there. That, even now, would be a step too far. It's starting to have an effect on the team, I think. I know I've been caught up in the moment once or twice. Just a second or two, forgetting that he's not a real boy. Still, I think we'll need to consider restricting him to the lab only for the moment. I'm well aware that others are put off by his presence. If I were slightly more arrogant, I might consider that a sign of success.
Doctor.
Oh, it's you. You're not authorized to be here.
Actually, I was looking for you.
Me? Why?
Let's just say that you've regained the attention of a certain group that I represent.
Stop beating around the bush. I knew it was just a matter of time before your people would track me down. I've been looking over my shoulder for almost a decade, waiting for them to send someone like you to kill me.
I'm only here with good intentions. You have my word.
You're giving me your word, even though we just met? Fine. Since Father trusts you, I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt. I might not agree with everything he says, but I know he'd never allow harm to come my way. Say what you came here to say, and then...
Are you happy here?
You'd think being surrounded by cutting-edge laboratory equipment and some of the greatest minds the world's ever known would be enough. Only problem is the lack of transparency. I don't think we get the full story on everything that occurs down here. What does that have to do with why we're talking?
The Brotherhood needs your help, Doctor.
Needs my help? Why? They seem to have everything under control when I left.
Did you abandon any projects you wanted to complete?
You should know better than to ask me that. If they didn't tell you what I was working on, they didn't want you to know. I'm certainly not going to put my neck on the line and spread their dirty little secrets. Tell me something. Why would I possibly want to come crawling back to the Brotherhood? What reason would I have to throw away everything I've accomplished here?
Father trusts me, and so should you.
He trusts you because you're family. I'm not. I can't just take your word for it. I need more than that.
The Brotherhood has always been straight with you.
I am getting a bit tired of all the secrets around here. Sometimes I feel like Father isn't being straight with me. Like there are things I'm not supposed to know about. I don't like that. But still, how can I turn my back on all of this?
Your work could be instrumental in freeing the Commonwealth.
You really know how to push my buttons, don't you? You know, I never understood why the Institute was so damn selfish. All those innocent people up there, dying. Yet we hide down here and insulate ourselves from everything and everyone. It's not right. It's not right. I'll make my way back to the Brotherhood. But I'm going to have to do it on my own. Tell whoever sent you that they've just regained the services of Dr. Madison Lee. Now, for the sake of keeping up appearances, let me see that Pip-Boy of yours. I've been told to install a coarser chip in it for you. Father's orders. You're to be given full access, with the ability to relay in and out of the Institute at will.
Thank you.
Given that the relay is the only way to access the Institute, handy is something of an understatement. In case the significance is lost on you, you'll be the only one here with that kind of access. If nothing else, it should demonstrate the amount of trust Father has placed in you. Speaking of, I trust our discussion will remain between the two of us.
Sure.
case anyone didn't mention it, quiet time runs from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m.
Primary drive servo.
That's a
doctor.
Oh, I don't kidding. Know.
You really
most
are.
Of them have lasted long past right. their projected lifespans.
I'm Al.
If you Al ask me,
you can think of me as the
well.
Institute's chief engineer. When Father told us about you, I could hardly believe it. You've been through so much. I think most people would have just given up. If you don't mind my asking, what was it that kept you going all that time?
I wanted to kill the son of a bitch who murdered my husband.
Kellogg always was a cold bastard. Now, I'll give you a quick rundown of the facilities division, and as you might guess, we keep the Institute's mechanical and electrical systems running smoothly. We maintain and upgrade all of the systems that make it possible to live and work in a place like this. There's a lot of machinery behind these walls that recycles the air and water and provides power to the laboratories and quarters. The work we do might not be as exciting as some of the other departments, but it's at least as important. So, now that you're here and you've spoken to Father, does that mean you're on board?
On board with what?
The Institute, of course.
Right.
Sean implied you operated on a level, if not equal, and at least similar to the rest of us. Curious. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the Facilities Division, I'm happy to discuss it.
Who built this place, originally?
The construction of the Institute is the work of generations of scientists. The original survivors of the war, our progenitors, took refuge in the basement of the old Commonwealth Institute of Technology. Over time, their sons and daughters dug deeper into the earth and built increasingly sophisticated habitats and laboratories. It's a process that's still going on today.
Right.
Just think what this place will look like 100 years from now.
I can't argue with that. Even so,
Dr.
There we
Fillmore.
Go.
All
Hi
set.
There.
Unit, Something you I can return to duty.
It must be a challenge to meet the power demands of a place like this.
Absolutely.
Uh-huh.
Over the years, we've learned a few tricks that help supplement our power budget. When necessary, we can tap into select sources on the surface.
Mm-hmm.
Fortunately, Advanced Systems is always working on new solutions to generate more energy. It's a good thing, too, because the demand is always increasing. You don't even want to know what a single use of the molecular dematerializer consumes. Thanks again.
Of course.
Dr. Carlin's doing some amazing things with our genetically engineered crops.
Doc?
Welcome. So good to have you here. Dr. Clayton Holdren, head of the Bioscience Division. I can't wait for you to see the work we're doing. It's truly amazing.
I look forward to learning more about it.
In that case, let me give you a brief overview of what we do here. As the name implies, the Bioscience Division specializes in fields of study such as botany, genetics, and medicine. Our most important directive is to ensure the health and well-being of everyone in the Institute. To that end, we cultivate highly specialized breeds of flora for use in food and medicine. We've even started to explore the idea of synthetic animal life. You probably saw the gorillas. They're really just a pet project at this point, but the potential is exciting nonetheless.
Seems like there's nothing you guys can't do.
With hard work and ingenuity, any challenge can be overcome. I'm sure I've taken up enough of your time as it is, but I have to ask, have you decided whether you'll join us?
I'm not sure how well I'll fit in, but I'd like to give it a try.
Great. I was hoping you'd say that. In any case, I imagine you'll want to continue looking around.
Is there anything I can do to help out?
I think Dr. Carlin was looking for help with...
Hi, Doc.
Well, well, if it isn't our visitor from the past. Some time ago, we covertly replaced the family patriarch at Warwick Homestead with a synth. He's been field testing a variety of genetically modified seeds that I created. Take this packet of seeds to the Roger Warwick synth. Be careful with these. They represent years of genetic manipulation and enhancement. Hopefully you can manage such a simple task.
Don't patronize me, Pencil Neck.
All right, now listen closely, because this next part is vitally important. When Roger asks how your trip was, tell him some blood bugs chased you halfway across the Commonwealth. That code phrase will identify you as an agent of the Institute. Also, you must be discreet.
Sure. And if your synth has been compromised?
Then you'll have to improvise. Now hurry on to Warwick Homestead so we can...
Humanity's future is taking root right here.
Dr. Holdren's synth gorilla project is showing promising results. Father's a great man. You must be very proud.
Personal record, Dr. Brian Virgil. This will likely be my last recording. My requests to shut down the FEV program have repeatedly been denied. We've learned nothing useful in the last 10 years. Why does Father insist on continuing it? If he won't see reason, then I have to take matters into my own hands. What we're doing is not right. You need to stop. Understand me. I'm gonna make sure the whole program is shut down. If not for good, then at least for years to come.
Yes.
After that.
Yes.
I know what I'm about to do will be seen as a betrayal. Treason. I have a plan.
Everything that we've done.
And if it works, our lives are safe. Somewhere not even the Corsos
are
my
God.
May he have mercy on us all.
Yeah.
Standing down.
Situation.